It's such a difficult name for me to say, and I'm very sure there is so many other people that feel the same way. So can you repeat that for me again?
Yeah, well, my name is Hariadne Bo. Mm-hmm. So it's a Greek name. Bo,
Greek name?
Yeah, Greek is Hariadne. It's like Ariadne, but with a H. Okay. And Bo is French.
And tell me something, Harry, can I call you Harry?
Of course.
Okay, cool. So, you are 19 years old.
I am.
So young, and you have done so much.
Yeah, I started off very early. I started off at Sylvia Young's acting school when I was very, very young, doing commercials, toilet roll, things like that.
Toilet roll? Yeah. So you have done a few commercials?
Yeah, I've done commercials. And then I went on to doing haute couture modelling, and now it's expanded onto a great scale of... now being recognised as a bit of a supermodel.
My God.
So, yeah,
at this moment, what do you think is the biggest achievement that you have had so far? What are the roles, what are things that you enjoy the most?
Probably how much I have expanded and from going from a haute couture model into what I'm being recognised as now. Mm-hmm. It seems like such a great leap in such a short amount of time and all by myself. So I'm not agency, I haven't got an agency, I'm all freelance. Mm-hmm. I have.
And you're not looking for an agency as well?
Definitely not, it's out of choice. I've got a PR company that specialises with cars because I've just become the face of the Tushek, which is a Slovenian supercar. So Angie Valuti would be my PR for that. I have another PR and manager, which it all goes through my mum directly first. And then I've got another manager, so they sort of work together. Charlie K at 7 PR Management. So
that's
sort of,
good.
Yeah, I've got a big team behind me, but I have started all on my own.
You're just 19.
Yes, just 19.
I love it.
Thank you.
Love it. Well done.
Thank you.
I'm not your mum, but I'm proud of that.
Thank you.
Honestly.
Yeah, I do feel like it's an achievement.
It is very easy to judge people, and it's very easy to point another person and to criticise, but very rarely people come and tell you, you know, we're proud of you.
Yeah, I don't hear it a lot, to be honest, not in this industry. I get a lot of criticism through people, especially people who aren't in the industry. People want to bring you down all the time, so it is nice to hear.
I read somewhere that something that someone called you to be in something about Essex, so it's a program, and you turned it down. Could you just, it was a gossip, it was something real. I read something about it. Could you explain to me about this?
I got called by the Only Ways Essex production team, who asked me 3 times to go on the programme in different angles. There was one scene where they wanted me to bend over in front of Mark Wright and then look at my bum, different things like that. And it's just not what I want to go down a different route. I want to be like a high fashion model.
Okay.
So I'd like to I think that some people can sort of perceive you in a certain way if you do reality sometimes, which isn't good, but it's just the way it is, unfortunately. So I did turn it down. And then the national press, the Daily Star, got in contact with me and asked me if I'd do a big 2-page spread, etc. So I went into the Daily Star doing a two-page spread on why I turned it down. I've got a lot of things coming up at the minute. Uh-huh. I'm doing Essex Fashion Week, London Fashion Week, Pakistan Fashion Week.
Pakistan Fashion Week?
Yeah, I'm doing a lot of
Hold on a second in there. Why Pakistan?
To be honest, I enjoyed working with them. They were a great company and great organisation to work with.
Yes.
And it opens the doors into different cultures, different countries. Mm-hmm. So yeah, and I'm able to travel with different things as well. So it's,
have you been
it's
to exciting. Pakistan?
I've been to Pakistan, yes.
Karachi, Lahore?
I don't know.
Rawalpindi?
I can't pronounce it.
Yeah.
but I'm travelling to Milan soon with Face On magazine. Which is really exciting. That's in the next 2 weeks.
Are you going to be modelling?
I am. I'm modelling a new jewellery company. Richard Sumner from Face On magazine. He's involved in all of that. I'm working with one of the top international photographers, Mark Evans. So I'm quite excited about that too, in Milan. I'm trying to think what else. I'm going over to Slovenia soon because I just launched the Tushek, the new supercar, which is also quite exciting. And Jensen Interceptor.
Hopefully they give you one. Well, not really.
Yeah, I hope so.
Well, so the big plans going on.
Yeah.
What did you want to achieve?
I hope to be a household name. That's probably one of my, and I'm also designing scarves at the moment. I'm hoping to get them into Harrods and put them on Net-a-Porter.
Mm-hmm.
With this modelling, I hope to become well known.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, to travel a lot.
So not just being a model, do you want to be a business?
No, I want to be a business. Yeah, I want to be known with my name. I don't want to just be a model that walks the catwalk.
You want to brand yourself.
Yes, that's correct. I want to be known.
That is very important. Tell me now, in regards with modeling, and I hear that they call you the face.
Yes.
And obviously because you are gorgeous. Oh. But now tell me, in your face, what's the thing that you don't like about your face? I don't like so many things about a lot of part of my body, not just my face. But I love myself anyways.
What do you like about
yourself? To be honest, I think when you're young, you have a lot of insecurities about your face. You sort of think, I don't like this, I don't like that. Now that I'm a little bit older, I look at my face and I think, no, that's what makes me different. So it's not so much what I don't like, it's what makes me different. So I have a bump on my nose, and a lot of modelling agencies have come to me and pointed it out and said to me, we like that. So my insecurities when I was younger are actually the things that make me wanted now within the modelling industry. I think whatever young girls even out there think about their face, in years' time, they'll be the things that make them who they are.
Would you consider to have plastic surgery?
No. Definitely not.
You're happy with your body?
Yeah, 100%.
So, now, what are your biggest fears? And I'm going to end up with that. What is your biggest fear?
Biggest fear? Because I'm so driven, would probably be to not make it to where I want to be. So, I want to make it to a certain point, and if I don't get there, the fear probably drives me to it. So, I'm trying to get there even more because of the fear. So, that would be my fear, to not achieve what I want to.
Very good. So thank you so much for being with us.
It
has been a great pleasure, and we wish you all luck in the future.
Thank you for having me on here. I've had a great time.